Hello everyone! In this video I show how I decorate a wooden cheese board and four matching coasters. I'm going to try the acrylic bloom technique again because I'm still experimenting with the different supplies, and I'm also going to use some nice Christmas colors again, and so I hope you all enjoy watching the process of how I decorate a cheese board and matching coasters, and give me a thumbs up for it. So I'm starting with a cheese board. It's a wooden cheese board. It's 20 centimeters, so not that large. And I'm starting with a pillow paint. And the mix for the pillow paint is 300 gram white satin latex wall paint and 300 gram white regular wall paint in matte, and then 70 gram of water, and that is the pillow paint. The colors that I'm using, this one is the golden fluid acrylics in the color iridescent gold. Very nice. So I'm still experimenting with the mix of the pouring medium, because I'm using an untinted wood gel. And as soon as I think it's a good pouring medium, I will share what it is exactly. So the second color is one of my mica pigments. It's the Twinkling Forest. I'm going to try it again. And on top, the DecoArt Metallic fluid acrylics in the color green gold, and on top of that, one of my mica pigments, new colors, it's the Sassy Red, a fluorescent color. So at the end of this video, in the close-up, I'm also going to try to show you how this color lights up. And this time I'm using a colored cell activator, and it's one of my mica pigments. It's called Sangria, so hopefully this will work. Yeah, I'm so sorry that my head is in the way, but yeah. But this is an experiment also with a colored cell activator, so you can see I still need to practice on my blow, because also blowing on top of that cell activator is very important to create that beautiful lacing. So now it still doesn't look nice, but I'm waiting a little bit to see if it changes or not. Blow on it again. Still have a lot of paint on my cheese board, so I need to pour off a lot of paint. Because if I leave too much on my surface, then I have a risk that the paint will crack, because the layer is too thick. And what I also mentioned in previous videos, but I still wanted to try it anyway, is the Twinkling Forest is not that suitable to use in an untinted base paint. Because the particle size of that mica pigment, it is too large. You can see that it separates. But I still wanted to try it for a second time. But the Sassy Red looks great. Also, the DecoArt green gold, and I'm getting more lacing of the Sangria cell activator that I made out of a mica pigment. So the pouring medium mix is an untinted wood gel, three parts, and one part Joe Sonia's polyurethane gloss varnish. So that's the pouring medium. And how I mixed the fluid acrylics, 20 drops of the paint and 30 gram of pouring medium. Now I'm going to show you the four coasters, what I mentioned in the beginning, the same pillow paint. But this is another color, it's the Vallejo Fluid Acrylics in the color Fluorescent Green. On top, a mica pigment, the Real Teal, also a new color. On top of that, the Sassy Red, also a mica pigment. Then the Aurora Gold, it's an iridescent color, also one of my newer mica pigments. Then the Sassy Red again. And this time I'm going to use a black cell activator that I made out of the Amsterdam Lamp Black and three parts of Australian Flutrol. So 5 gram paint, 15 gram Australian Flutrol. But all the mixes I will add in the description below this video, so you can read it. But I have the coaster on my spinner, or spinning wheel. But so you can see, I can already see that the green has disappeared. But still some nice lacing. So what I mentioned, the pouring medium mix is 3 parts untinted wood gel and 1 part Jo Sonja's polyurethane gloss varnish. How I mixed the mica pigments, 1 tablespoon of mica pigment and 1 gram of Jo Sonja mix. And the mix is 3 parts Jo Sonja and 1 part water. And I added 30 gram of pouring medium. But yeah, it's a lot of information. So all the information to the mix is in the description below this video. But I'm still experimenting with all the different mixes. But I want to show you anyway. So if it doesn't look nice, then that's no problem for me. But this one looks nice. Has some nice black lacing. So at the end of this video, a close-up. And also, I'm going to try to show you the fluorescent color, the Sassy Red, because I used it on the cheese board, but also on the coasters. So again, the pillow paint. And what I also read from other artists and what I see in videos is that the consistency of the paints is very important. So not too thin, but also not too thick. So it's depending on a lot of factors to create that nice lacing. This is the DecoArt Metallic Green, Forest Green, and the Aurora Red on top. And what I also want to mention is that the cell activator that I made out of the Sangria mica pigment, I also added the Liquitex Gloss and Matte Gel Medium to thicken that paint and then add the Australian Flutrol. Again, some nice lacing. And also that green from Vallejo is fluorescent, so hopefully that will also light up. But that is in the close-up at the end of this video. Yeah, I need to spin off a lot of paint, because otherwise it will crack during drying. Because that's what I also learned. But this one looks also very pretty. You can see the Aurora Red shimmering. And the third one, again, the pillow paint. I'm still working on a mixing video. But yeah, I can show you that video if I'm totally satisfied with the pouring medium mix and all the other mixes I'm using. And what I also experience is that you need to use a lot of transparent colors or semi-transparent, because then you get the nice effect of the lacing. So not too much opaque colors. And the cell activator is best to use if the paint is opaque. So the lamp black is an opaque color, but also titanium white by Amsterdam. Again, some nice lacing. And these coasters and cheese board will not get a resin layer. They will get a few layers, thin layers of gloss varnish. And the cheese board is not food safe, but you can make it food safe by adding a food safe resin layer or a food safe gloss varnish, because that you can buy. But I'm not going to do that, because I will have the decoration for decoration, the cheese board, so not to use for cheese or something else, but it's only for decoration. So the last coaster, starting with the fluorescent green, on top the Aurora gold, no, red, sorry, then the real teal, and the sassy red. And the black cell activator. I'm also experimenting with another cell activator, because the Australian Flutrol we can't buy here in the Netherlands soon anymore. So I will I'm experimenting with different supplies that are easy to buy, and to hopefully create the same effects as with the Australian Flutrol. Also, this one has some nice lacing. So far, I'm very pleased how they look. Hopefully, they will dry very well. Yeah, there's still a lot of paint on my coaster. Yeah, and all the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description below this video. So if you are interested in the mica pigments, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. The link to her Etsy shop is also in the description box. So this is right after pouring, a close-up of the coasters. Yeah, I'm very pleased with the lacing. Looks amazing. Hopefully this will light up, because this is the sassy red. Very nice. And there you can see the Aurora red shimmering, because for this coaster I only used green colors and the Aurora red. And for this one also, together with the fluorescent green from Vallejo. Yeah, some great lacing. So hopefully they will dry this way. Again, the Aurora Red. So I will let this dry, and off camera I will add a few thin layers of gloss varnish, and after that's dry I will show you all the end result. So this is the end result. First I'm using a UV lamp to show you how the sassy red is glowing. There you can see it, it lights up. I'm so pleased with that new mica pigment. So nice. There you can see it again. I'm also going to show you the coasters. Here you can see them. Again, the sassy red, but also a little bit of the fluid acrylic from Vallejo, the fluorescent green. Yeah, I'm very happy with how they look. But it's very difficult to film this with a UV lamp. But yeah, I'm trying. So I hope you like my coasters. I will also show you them in daylight, because then they also look very pretty. Yeah, very nice. So this is how they look outside in the daylight, and you can still see the structure a little bit because I didn't add resin. I added 6 thin layers of gloss varnish, but I think they look amazing. Very nice lacing, and you can see the Aurora Red shimmering. Also the Sassy Red looks very nice in daylight. And what I'm also pleased about is the cell activator that I made out of the mica pigment Sangria, also one of my mica pigments. So I'm very happy with this experiment, so let me know what you think. All the information to the supplies I've used you can find below this video in the description. There's a lot of information there. Very nice. So I also have some promo codes, also those are in the description, and I have my own Facebook group, so if you use my Just Paint supplies, please come and join me and share your art on my page, because I'm very curious what you create with it. So I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye!